and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Before we celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge that we are sinners. And above all, let us acknowledge that God is merciful. I confess to thee, Almighty God, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I failed to do, through my faults, through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who renew the world through mysteries beyond all telling, grant, we pray, that your church may be guided by your eternal design and not be deprived of your help in this present age. This is our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, now I create new heavens and a new earth, and the past will not be remembered, and I will come no more to men's minds. Be glad and rejoice forever and ever for what I am creating, because I now create Jerusalem, joy and her people gladness. I shall rejoice over Jerusalem and exult in my people. No more will the sound of weeping or the sound of cries be heard in her. In her no more will be found the infant living a few days only, or the old man not living to the end of his days. To die at the age of 100 will be dying young. Not to live to be 100 will be the sign of a curse. They will build houses and inhabit them, plant vineyards and eat their fruit. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The response: I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me, and have not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you have raised my soul from the dead, restored me to life from those who sink into the grave. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. Sing psalms to the Lord, you who love him. Give thanks to his holy name. His anger lasts but a moment, his favor through life. At night there are tears, but joy comes with the dawn. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. The Lord listened and had pity. The Lord came to my help. For me you have changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord my God, I will thank you forever. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My soul is waiting for the Lord, I count on his word. Because with the Lord there is mercy and a fullness of redemption. Lord,
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus left Samaria for Galilee. He himself had declared that there is no respect for a prophet in his own country. But on his arrival, the Galileans received him well, having seen all that he had done at Jerusalem during the festival which they too had attended. He went again to Cana in Galilee, where he had changed the water into wine. Now there was a court official there whose son was ill at Capernaum, and hearing that Jesus had arrived in Galilee from Judea, he went and asked him to come and cure his son, as he was at the point of death. Jesus said, "So you will not believe unless you see signs and portents." "Sir," answered the official, "come down before my child dies." "Go home," said Jesus, "your son will live." The man believed what Jesus had said and started on his way. And while he was still on the journey back, his servants met him with the news that his boy was alive. He asked them when the boy had begun to recover. "The fever left him yesterday," they said, "at the seventh hour." The father realized that this was exactly the time when Jesus had said, "Your son will live." And he and all his household believed. This was the second sign given by Jesus on his return from Judea to Galilee. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The prophet Isaiah uses images that are really in that time for the people of Israel as they were about to end their exile. God promising them a future which they could not make themselves, but they were invited to receive this future from the hands of the Creator. He told them, "Now I create new heavens and a new earth. The past will not be remembered." When we hear this word from the mouth of God, in this actual situation we are in, we see the promise of God. And it is really promising to hear of a new world, a new earth, where healing is possible. When everyone comes to one's own limit to bring about solutions, it is now God to invite us and see what He is creating. And this journey of creation, a new creation, He started not only in the creation we are told at the beginning of the scriptures, but in Jesus Christ, his own Son, who has come so that we may have life and life in its fullness. When we encounter him healing the son of the court official in Galilee, we can always also say that this is the Jesus we accept in our midst to bring about what we ourselves cannot do. The official said, "My son is at the point of death. Come and cure him." Today we can say, we are all threatened. The whole world is in panic. We have no clue of how to go out of this. Our refuge is Jesus. Come, Lord, and heal us. We are at the point of death. And this death is not only a physical death, but maybe also a spiritual death. That at times we are not alive spiritually, and we invoke the Lord to come and raise us up from our sleep. We shall recognize the sign of that what God is doing in our midst if we deepen our faith. This healing of the official's son was the second sign given by Jesus. He had turned water into wine at Cana. Now he is healing. All these signs, other gospels would call them miracles, are signs of the presence of God with his people. Let us ask the Lord to strengthen our faith in him who is creating us anew, who creates the future for us, and who has promised to be with us through all our struggles. Omukama atugamba, ntimulabe kati nkola eggulu eppya n'ensi empya. Kati nga tuli mu kusoomoozebwa okw'enjawulo mu ensi yonna, tumutunuulire tulabe ky'akola. Atonda ensi empya era atuwa obulamu obw'omu maaso, ng'ekitunasobozesa okufuna kino ky'atuwa kwe kukkiriza. Emirandira gyaffe tugisimbe mu ye, tetujja kuterebuka olw'okubanga Omukama yatusuubiza okubeera naffe bulijjo. Omukama abeere nawe.
Accept this sacrifice at my hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May we receive, O Lord, we pray, the effects of this offering dedicated to you, so that we may be cleansed from all earthly ways and be renewed by growth in heavenly life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeling of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, the hand of our bodies. Make holy therefore this gift, we pray, by sending down the Spirit upon them like they before, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and a drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Cyprian, our Bishop, the clergy, the religious, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember your servants, especially those who have lost the battle, the coronavirus. They have come to you, their Creator. Grant that they who have been united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that we, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, we Saint Joseph, our most chaste spouse, the Blessed Apostles, Saint Daniel Comboni, the martyrs of Uganda, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Obedient to the Master's command and ready to be formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace nowadays, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. not on our sins, but on the faith of the church, and on the efforts of all people of goodwill to bring about lasting peace. Graciously grant the entire human family peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
I will place my spirit within you and make you walk according to my laws and my judgments, and you shall keep and observe them, says the Lord. Let us pray. May your holy gifts, O Lord, we pray, give us life by making us new, and by sanctifying us, lead us to things eternal. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Through Mary, we ask God to protect us and show us ways out of this pandemic.
We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You, salvation of the followers of your Son, know that we need what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father, and to do as we are taught by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Under your protection we seek refuge, Holy Mother of God. Do not disdain our entreaties now that we are in trial, but deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Renew your people within and without, O Lord, and since it is your will that they be unhindered by bodily delights, give them, we pray, perseverance in their spiritual intent. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless and protect you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mercies end. Let us stay with the peace of Christ. I wish you all a blessed day.